And today I changed this material to Factory of the Future. This is a kind of a previous program, research program inside Europe, EU program. And then they, based on this research program, it comes out of smart manufacturing and also Industry 4.0. So you can see how it is worked before then, the smart factory or Industry 4.0. I'm trying to show you one video and one slide coming from EU program. It is not my own. And Yubin will cover the core technologies, which is important and used for Factory of the Future. Right. So let me start with a video. I send you the list of videos, but I also include two more this morning. And then here is slide is, but one of them I'm trying to cover this one for as a class this morning. But there are more slides you can find from the Google. So here's the slide. This is coming from Siemens Factory of the Future. There are different videos, like see here you see that there's Airbus videos and other companies provide the Factory of the Future videos. But I found this Siemens is more comprehensive, so you can see their views. This is about there are sensors and robot is important component. And VR is also important. So robots, sensors, and VR, and 3D printing too. It's from Boeing. Huh? He also mentioned about CPS and automotive industry or thank you. customization, mass customization. So you can see that this one is from Siemens, but Siemens, even though prepared by Siemens, but you notice that it is from UK. Siemens, although Siemens is a German company, the Beetle comes from probably Siemens UK. And you see that from the video that is MTC. MTC is a manufacturing technology center of UK. So they are involved with the Siemens and then Nico. So this is related to Industry 4.0. I hope you noticed that at the end of the video they are mentioning about Industry 4.0. All right, this is a slide I'm trying to cover for the, as an overview. This is I found from the Google. So this is from the European Factory of the Future Research Association. So it's an overview of their association on what they are doing. So you see that this is a European program. Factory of the Future itself is a European program. And then is a consortium of members of industrial enterprise, research organization, university, and association. This is a consortium, right? Association. And there are some full-time secretariat. There's a usual way they are doing. And innovation for manufacturing. This is a EU program, research program. The factory of the future itself is a and whole budget in euro, it's a billion around And the final year for target is 2020. So they has a similar situation for Industry 4.0. There are 200 projects and 1,000 organizations involved participating, and international and European collaboration. Right. And they identify six research priority areas. Area means domains of technology. And also they annually they call new topics, so they revise and upgrade their programs. So you see here the six domains. One is advanced manufacturing process and on the smart manufacturing systems. Already they are using smart there. Right? This is about process, more about, and this is about system, you see? And digital and virtual factory, and then collaboration and mobile. And the other one is human-centered manufacturing, where the robots are used. And then about customization, custom focusing on this. And enabling technology are such as economic, social, environmental, and then processes and mechatronics, information technology, and knowledge workers, and modeling and simulation. There is a, will be covered, I hope, by Yubin. And one of the important items they are talking about is Internet of Things. So we already see it many times. Well, under that, the six domains covers the IoTs, each of them, right? And another one is one of the project called the preview is focusing on predictive system to recommend the injection mold. Injection mold is for the plastic making, such as this one. They has a mold, and then plastic was heated to be a fluid, and then injected into the mold to make. So injection mold is something like a making plastic product, and process optimization, and a wireless sensor network, and data acquisition system, prediction system, and the wireless capability is a keyword they are there. And preview still same project is a middleware solution and information sharing. So you can see this here is a step is also used for information sharing. So sharing of product and process information across the whole process. So wireless information process is used for data acquisition, predictive system, and wireless capability. And another one project is menu intelligence. So manufacturing and intelligence is together. It is about cross-disciplinary collaborative about product service design and manufacturing for intelligent engineering platform. So their overview is like this one, menu intelligence. And you can find more information from the website. There is a, you see that Dassault systems are involved there. This is a logo of Dassault system. And there is a database. There's a product design and simulation validation and process design for manufacturing execution. And Internet of Things is also coming. And life cycle service. All things are coming for the sequence of whole life cycle of the product. Another project they are talking about, ILAMP3. This is for network devices. So it transforms conventional production equipment. Production equipment, like one of them is robots. Right? Robot is production equipment or conveyor belt. And then they want to make that equipment as a network-enabled devices. So they're talking about agent-based production devices, And they, because it is agent, they can, the device can adapt themselves to environment, such as I saw when I visiting German last January, say, each workstation, they have a sensor that when I, as a worker, arrive, they sense my ID, and then they has a database of my situation. Say, I'm taller in this much, and my eye capability, and how much I am old. So based on information, the configuration of the workstation is changes. Something like one simple example is a lighting system. Change it, because old people usually need a lighter workplace. And also adapting their height of the desk, something like that. So that the efficiency can be increased, as because there are so many different workers are shifting and changing. Old people, young lady, there are lots of different people are working together. So this is adaptable production equipment cases. And sensors and sensor grid, fast component integration and rapid adaptation. Alliance for Internet of Things Innovation. There are working groups for IoT technology. And so the working group 1, 2, 3, 4, and then also 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 for manufacturing and other things. And EU member states are working together to collaborate for technology. Internet of Things also. One of them is working group 11 is about manufacturing. There are some information about that. And still going on, and then there is innovation workshops about event and activities. ICT, FOF, and Internet of Things are together. This is a program of their work. And then finally, there are some more information there. So once again, IFRA is a European Factory of the Future Research Association, so that you have more information from their homepage and project consortium members. Okay. So overview of Factory. So once again, Factory of the Future is a EU research program. EU, all together of European countries. About money of 1 billion euro. And that was the baseline of Smart Factory and Industry 4.0. So outgrowth of that program, you have now Industry 4.0. All right, questions? Then Yubin can take over.
Hello, my name is Yubin Kim, and I'm going to talk about enabling technologies. As the professor said, there is the many technologies which in the industrial 4.0. This is the content. There is the kind of technologies like IoT and machine-to-machine communication and cloud-based application and data analytics, smart robotics, and integrated product production simulation, and additive manufacturing, and another future technologies. This is the introduction. The technologies. In this case, the technologies means specific technologies in order to implement factory of the future concept. And usually, these technologies, in many cases, does not correspond to the expectations placed on them, because it requires much time after promises have been made. The downside picture, it addresses you to the technologies that is located, where it's located. The y-axis means the expectation, and x-axis means the time. So the IoT, for example, the IoT, its expectation is very high, and it is located in the peak of inflated expectations. And then the machine-to-machine communication service is located through the disillusionment. So it getting lower expectations, but the memory analytics is getting high expectations, and in case of speech recognition, it is in the plateau of productivity. So the emerging technologies means it is that are observed with specific attention, or that are believed will have a specific impact in the future. Then I'm going to talk about IoT and M2M. IoT is used to link any types of objects in the physical world having a virtual representation or identity in the internet. We already learned about CPS, but I don't remember about the CPPS. So, but this kind of concept, both of which will be core building blocks of the factory of the future. The machine-to-machine, the M2M communication or integration refers to the set of technologies and networks that provide connectivity and interoperability between machines in order to allow them to interact. So, and there is five main tenets. First, smart devices provide the raw data and analysis and closed-loop feedback that are utilized to automate and manage process control systems at every stage of manufacturing. And then these devices are connected and embedded and widely used. So using these devices, the control systems will become more flexible and complex and widely distributed. And the wireless technologies will tie these separate devices and then control the modules together. And actionable intelligence will become increasingly important because it will be possible to anticipate and account for all of the environmental changes to which control systems will need to respond. Continuing IoT and M2M, IoT solution requires three main solutions, components made up of various technologies. It is composed by edge and network and core. Edge contains cloud equipment and device and sensor, and network contains SIM-based and internet protocols and wired and wireless. And core has workflows and operate and administration and device integration and store. And in this slide, I don't know about SIM. So
SIM
based. So, Professor, do you know about this? But the network is a tie, the edge and core. So edge is collecting and communicating more information than ever before. And network provides the connectivity for all integrated devices. And core is using edge info for managing core processes through the network. SIM card? I don't know this exactly about SIM. And next, the cloud-based application, infrastructure, and middleware. IoT solutions must have the ability to store the large volume of historical and diverse data. So we need some cloud systems. I think you already know about the cloud systems. And so it makes cloud and fog computing appropriate components of IoT implementations. And cloud technology paired with mobile devices is providing transparency and visibility of information and at every location and time. And cloud-based solutions will allow manufacturing enterprises to reduce the required core computing infrastructure and will enable them to respond flexibly to changing infrastructure needs. And this technology is about data analytics. In case of the in-memory database computing, it is helping to address the challenges of IoT big data. And it removes the constraints of existing business intelligence mechanisms. And then it gets the information about, it gets the important information about the whole data. And it delivers information for making strategic as well as operational business decisions in real time. And extraction of knowledge from this data without free fabrication of information and requests. And the data analytics recently contains the two concepts, ESP and CEP. ESP means event stream processing, and it makes it possible to stream, process, and filter and group all of the IoT data. And CEP, it is more sophisticated capability, which searches for complex pattern and the complex order sequence. Using the ESP and CEP, we can make decision in the mechanisms. And it allows IoT to drive business objective automatically. And the next technology is about smart robotics. It is an example of smart robotics, the human-robot collaboration. And this is enabled by integrating real-time context awareness and safety mechanisms into robotic systems, combines the flexibility of humans with the precision, force, and performance of robots. There exists three types of human-robot collaboration, cooperation, synchronized cooperation, and simultaneous cooperation, and assisted cooperation. For instance, this right side of picture is shows assisted cooperation, and it is being the closest type of human-robot collaboration in which the same component is operated by human operators and robots together without physical separation. But such collaboration presents safety issues. Because failures of the involved active robot might result in fatal injuries. Moreover, currently, no industry safety standards and regulations exist covering this type of human-robot collaboration, so Both innovation of system integration technologies and creation of new safety standards are regulations are required. And this is about flexibility of collaboration. It can be implemented not only for human-robot interaction, but also for collaboration among robotic systems. As I mentioned, the M2M system can help these kind of issues. Advanced robots can enhance sensory perception and dexterity, mobility, and intelligence in real time. Using technologies such as M2M, communication, machine vision, and sensors. And these kind of technologies can make such robots capable of communicating or interacting much more easier with one another. And next, new robot programming paradigms. The shift from programming robots to training robots intuitively is enabled by new robot operation engines. And the skills of robot and related tools are to be managed and mapped to production process requirements. And this causes the required time for programming the robot and the necessary skill set of engineers will be significantly reduced. And next technology is about integrated product and production simulation. The digital factory concept refers to an integrated approach to enhancing product and production engineering processes and simulation. And this needs the vision attempts to improve product and production at all levels by using different type of simulation. And the ultimate objective is to create a fully virtual product and production development, testing, and optimization. But traditionally, product and production design are separated. So this causes a sequential process in which any changes produce additional cost and delays. So simulation tools for both products are production concentrate on various details, such as logistics regarding material routes, cycle times, or buffer sizes, process such as assembly or machining. And although the trend is towards an integrated product production simulation capability, it should be noted that feedback information loops exist that need to be put in place to take full advantage of simulation tools. The real world provides the information to the simulated world, and to optimize current or future designs of products and factories. And then it gets feedback about potential improvements of the actual process automation and production systems. And this picture is about the connectivity between real world and the virtual world. In the virtual world, the product, factory, and plant design first exchange information to optimize both. And next technology is about additive manufacturing and 3D printing. A major aspect of integrating digital and physical worlds is the transfer of product specification to executable production processes. And the machining equipment or 3D printer help to keep associated configuration efforts low and thereby support the production. Actually, the global market of additive manufacturing products and services grew 29% in 2012 to over $2 billion US dollar in 2013. 3D printing allows manufacturing to work economically with a large variety of shapes and geometries, including for small product quantities. This situation caused the potential to transform some parts of the production industry from mass production to individual production. And another possible consequence is the shift in the role of manufacturers from designing and producing products to designing and selling the specification and plans. And this is the final slide of my presentation. It's about the additional factory of the future technologies. And these technologies, various other fields of research and development exist with which might provide relevant solutions for the factory of the future. So, for example, the augmented reality, wearable computing and exoskeletons, smart materials, and advanced and intuitive programming techniques or knowledge management systems will maybe it can be the other the main technologies of future. Yeah, thanks. Is there any questions?
SIM is same as the SIM card or smartphone. It's something like subscriber identification module.
And yeah.
Same also similar name as the SIM card. SIM. So that chip is used for identifying the chip.
So the SIM means SIM is acting like identify some product?
Any object. So it is short name of subscriber identification module. And we are using for smartphone.
Okay.
The SIM card or SIM card. But that can be used for many functions.
Yeah, thanks for your information.
Okay, so now let's start off. Discussion session. So today's big one is step is really necessary or not. So this is a background information. So the standard for the exchange of product model data, like for this 10303, and contains the product information models, which covers almost most of the aspects of product lifecycle management. So in the designing of ontology of knowledge based on concerning of any aspect of PLM, so it is necessary to use such kind of product information modules. But unfortunately, a module based on step is based on express language, so which is not compatible and with the common technologies for ontology creation. So here are some, this is the problem. So now we're going to discuss that is step really important. So we can start from the pros and cons. So for the pros, so we have for this express language, and it's quite necessary for this ontology creation. And also we can discuss its usage and data. So for the cons, so yeah, here are some like the problems also for that, like data leakage and different complexity, and even the necessity for updating and etc. So we can discuss the first topic one, and so we're gonna divide into two groups. So
can you explain the technologies for
ontology creation is just like ontology. Means entity, so it's kind of like a make a entity product, and so the problem is for in this process is the expressed language, because it's not compatible with some technologies, common technologies. So this is a very serious problem for the step. And
can you give us an example?
Okay.
Our board over there on the top.
Yes.
Our college web language. And RDF and RDFF is five. That are all WCC standard. WCC web standard. Worldwide web standard.
Yes.
Our and
RDF.
What is the school? Semantics is a meaning. Topology is meaning and also the structure and reasoning.
Reasoning
is included in topology. But semantics is only for meaning. Meaning and reasoning is together.
Okay. So this is the basic information about the step, like for its expressed language. So so we're gonna discuss the pros and cons. So who won't be the pros?
Should offend.
Okay, so my model and Dongbok. See? You can choose and pros and cons. Okay, so Muhammad and Dongbok will be the pros and Yubin and Onsik will be the cons. Yeah, well, we can start thinking about this the expressed language problem, because it's not compatible with the common technologies. So
I have a question.
Yes. Is not compatible with this one. Yes. Yes, but it's indispensable for step. So we must use this language for the development. So
in this slide, it looks like expressed not good. But
yes, this is a problem.
Good.
Yeah, here, like I just mentioned, this expression language is because this is just a small hint for you. Yeah, you can start thinking about this item and.
Okay, so I think step is a developed technology. It's been developing for a while, and express language is an old language, but it's also apparently very powerful. It was chosen by the people making step. So to argue for step, I believe that we should probably use all these assets we have. We made a lot of standards ready made that we can use. Even if it's not compatible, it's not worth it throwing everything we did. We can maybe make translators or some bridging between two different languages. But just throwing it all and starting all over again may not be the wise choice, because we already did a lot of work in step, or a lot of work has been done in step. So I think it's important to keep it and to improve it and to maybe build bridges and consider it. So it's my opinion.
Yes.
So just as the role of the standard you see the kind of a state of the kind of so just think about the basic role of
that. Yeah. You can think about it. This like for the 10303, this is for the product information models. So
can you speak loudly so that the other guy can hear?
Because the basic law of standard range, which is step by step, is the basic law is to communicate, to collaborate with other people. So I just look at the basic law of that, then definitely essential and useful. Do you think this example and the when we exchange data between computer systems using the step, and the step is not perfectly fit the each system, so maybe some of the important data will be leaked. So there are a kind of risk in the step. So I think in the specific cases of the exchanging data, it is a direct exchange system is also needed. Not only the step is the best, direct exchange system is also needed.
Yeah. I think we're not building either a standard or a direct exchange. It's more about step versus one of the common technologies for probably. Step is necessary as an intermediary, like you mentioned before. But if you make translators from the two, every topic is too many, it's end-to-end, maybe on this one can fit it. But if you have an intermediate standard, you can make two end-to-end for everyone to talk about it. But even though there's information loss in the geometry, but I think this, like at least my understanding is that the base of the addition product by size imagine.
Yes.
Or the not the not step as a geometric standard, but step as a standard to describe knowledge of design, like why a certain feature exists or why it's not a geometric interface and so on. That's what I understand. So if you're arguing, if you're
I think step is complex in two ways. Geometrical expressing their structure. So yesterday I gave a lecture on early days of making standard. I think standard can be changed. Replaced by other standard.
So you mean for like here for this express language, it can be substituted by other languages?
Yes.
Yeah, but for step, as I know, the express languages are basic. Language for this step for this process, so there cannot be other ways to like to replace this language because it's a very basic description about this process.
I think the standard matters only for those who can use it. So even step is based on express language and it's not compatible with common technologies from the Pauli tradition. But if it's suitable and sufficient for the people using it,
that might not improve the quality better than what. So it's up to the people using it. If they think it's unnecessary or it's too limited, then at that point maybe you can change it. But as long as it's useful, then I think it's necessary.
Okay. Okay, so we don't have enough time, so the cross is a winner. So, okay, we're gonna go to the question two. We know that the product lifecycle management, but sometimes we have to choose the vendor first or the strategy first. Yeah, so this is a basic for the vendors. And sometimes, some crisis happened in this process. For example, the lagging sales and margins trading, and even like lower missed opportunities, and even emerging markets and warning letters, and even expensive recalls, and all kinds of problems happen. So that means we have to think about the vendors first, and. Sometimes for the companies, in order to solve this kind of product leadership and even the innovation challenges, so it's really important to develop the PLM strategy before selecting a vendor. So that means strategy comes first. And on the other hand, the paper-based managed systems turn out to be quite serial and fragmented and even slow. So, which means we have to focus on the strategy first and to improve its efficiency and so on. So,
can you give us an example of strategy first?
Okay, so. Yep. Company. Company. Actually, I don't have the exact companies to give you guys an example, but actually, this is the problems.
That really means supplier.
Yeah, supplier.
K&M vendor. Right?
Yes.
K&M,
yes.
Oh, the
maybe.
The software.
Yes.
The software.
Yes.
K&M. Supply. Software system maker.
Yes.
Yes. That's all. That is the software vendor.
Yes. In this process. Yes. So this time. Vendor first and strategy first.
Nowadays, PLM is a very developing technology, so a lot of people are doing research and adding features into the system. So by first choosing a good vendor and then studying the product's capabilities, you can make use of all the different strengths in the market and all the research that has been done either inside the company or university. So by choosing a vendor, good vendor, choosing the product and then analyzing its capabilities and using as many of them as you can, I think this can be very informative and useful for the company in the long term, especially. So that's one point why we should first.
Okay.
can say that this present coherent strategy is not perfect. So coherent strategy will be progressed. So as you mentioned in the slide,
yes.
The recall happened.
Mm-hmm.
You can good PRM strategies, you can manage the kind of big situations easily. So the pure strategy should be first.
You can think about Toyota.
Yeah.
Before that, it's brake. The brake has some problems. So at that time, the car has been recalled because of that. So you can think about this case and the car. The brake has some problems because of the vendors. Yes.
This time is harder than hardware.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but it's
so
for.
Which one is
your? Actually, the vendors means like software and both software and hardware.
But it's different company. So Spring vendor is a hardware supplier, right?
GS
is
TN
software supply.
Yes.
So which one do you mean?
Okay, so let's like the
so
hardware.
Means, what vendor should I choose?
Like for here, like we should because we should solve like the product leadership and even innovation challenges. So sometimes we should develop a new kind of PLM strategy before selecting a vendor. So that means we have to be dominant in the market. And for this process, and even before that, the paper-based like PLM management systems are very slow and even low efficient. So we have to focus on the strategy first.
Mm-hmm.
And on the other hand, because of those so many accidents and even problems happened, so we should concentrate on the vendors first and try to improve the product lifecycle management process.
As I understand, vendor first tool is choose some PLM software and change the company's strategy or
structure. Yeah, just vendor first and strategy first and is means that we first, for example, we first choose a vendor, and then we make the strategy. And on the other hand, we choose a strategy first, and then select a vendor.
But I'm
confused
because in terms of software, the software is going to reflect the strategy on the proposal.
Yeah. For the strategy, and yeah, it's necessary, but it.
Choose because company's strategy was company strategy is maintained in 9 years, so such 30% vendor later, I think.
Confusing.
Yeah. I just have a small explanation about the first test debate.
Okay. And I'm trying to explain. You don't know about SGML, right? But you heard about SGML because of Dong is explained about this. This is a sequence of history. These are all standard. But this one is first developed in history. And then it comes to the HTML. And now we have XML. So it's a sequence of time. This shows the capability of the language. This is a language. So SGML is very capable language. But instead, it is very complex. HTML is most simple one, so that capability is low. And XML now is popular, but is in the middle between them. Why it comes this way? This one is developed by US military for their purpose. But because it is too heavy, too complex, but it's very good, capable. But it is not easy to implement that at that time, 20 years ago. And then it comes with the HTML. HTML is very small size, simplified version of SGML. Very simple, very small capability, but easy to implement. And HTML becomes very popular with the World Wide Web homepage website, and all the web pages are designed using HTML. So it's a big bang of success. Okay. And after success of HTML website, people are trying to have more capability of HTML. So they need to upgrade HTML. So there has been HTML 2, HTML 3, but finally arrived at XML now. So XML is coming late, but it is in the middle capability-wise. But there are some more. Right? So I'm trying to explain why you talk about Express. Express is very similar to SGML. Express. And competition with them, it's them is, say, OWL and XML and YAML. Okay? YAML and XML. And what is the relation with the step and express? We call these are all information modeling language. All right. Step is, what is it? Step is a product model. Or it can say simply CAD model. Right? It's more than CAD, but so you should differentiate between model and modeling language. So Express is a language to define or represent step model. Right? It's a language. Also, it is web ontology language, and XML and UML, unified modeling language, they are all competition with Express for information modeling language. But this is the first time before when Express is developed by stack community, ISO, there was no such languages. They are coming late. But nowadays, these are more popular, right? So they learn from express language. They, similar to SGML, they simplify and make more capability, small, efficiency or simplification and additional direction. There are new developments. So now stack community also moves to using these languages rather than Express. Even though Express is good, this is very similar to SGML. It's too good to implement. It's complex. STEM is also similar. It is too complex, too good, right, to implement. Anyway, I'm trying to explain. So my proposal to international community is we should go into similarly to easy step, or I'm saying, or step light. Step light. Or similar to Pepsi light. Right? So we need to make a simplified version of step for real usage of virtual factory. That is my proposal to them, because we have an experience like this, or like this. But anyway, I hope you can have a more understanding about what is language and model and complexity. All right, that's good enough for today. See you Monday.